Hello, Kingsman, and welcome back to PNN. My name is Mikan.
And I'm Rhea. Today we bring news on everything from updates on the cell phone policy and homecoming plans. Let's get into it.
At the end of last school year, the state of Indiana passed a bill stating that each public high school in the state has a stated rule regarding the cell phone policy. Penn's recently updated policy is against the use of cell phones during instructional time. CJ Vantine has more with the thoughts of Penn students and staff on how this rule is played out.
Starting this year, Penn High School has had a new cell phone policy due to statewide legislation that requires school districts to adopt policies banning students from having wireless devices during class, unless there is direct instruction or the student needs it for a medical reason. Although this policy faced controversial feedback originally, staff and students both agree it's going well.
I really haven't seen a lot of problems with the cell phone policy. For the most part, kids have had their phone away right when the bell rings. And if they, even if they forget right at the beginning of class, they've been really respectful and they've been putting their phones away. It's been great.
Without the usage of phones, I've been way more productive in school. Like, my academic improvement has been significantly well, and I've been less stressed and more productive when it comes to school assignments and projects.
Penn Associate Principal Mrs. Hendricks says that due to this positive student, staff, and parent feedback, the phone policy will stay in place for the foreseeable future.
So, you know, I think the plan right now is to stick with kind of what we started with, and then reevaluate as the school year goes on, probably about halfway through, and then at the end of the year, just to see, you know, get everybody's input. How did it work? Were there things we need to adjust since it's our first year doing it? Then we'll make any adjustments at that time.
She also says that there will now be disciplinary action taking place for students who go against the phone policy. Following the policy she laid out in the virtual class meetings. Signing off for PNN, I'm CJ Vantine. Now back to Mike and Rhea.
Thanks, CJ.
As one of the biggest events of the year, homecoming is making its way to Penn High School through a rigorous process of planning and dedication to ensure students have a good time.
The homecoming pep rally, parade, and game against Elkhart takes place on October 4th, and the dance the day after on October 5th.
Earlier this week, the League of Women's Voters visited our cafeteria to help register all who turn 18 before November 5th.
We need to engage the people who live here, the people who are citizens here, the people who have the right to vote when they turn 18 here. We want to engage them in the process of voting because it's so important. I would just encourage everybody to stay alert, to do your own research, to make your own decisions. So, your voice is your vote, so be heard, get registered, and show up at the polls.
If you miss this opportunity, it is not too late to register. Registration is still open until October 7th.
Also in senior-related news, College Go Week starts on Monday. This upcoming week is dedicated to all things college applications and admissions. Nate Zizzo is more.
Every year, colleges across Indiana celebrate what is known as College Go Week. It's a national initiative of the American College Application Campaign. The goal is to help high school seniors navigate the college admissions process and ensure each student submits at least one admissions application. Many Indiana universities join in the celebration by waiving college application fees for at least a week so students can apply for free. From September 23rd to 27th, the Penn Counseling Department plans to help students with this process even further. On Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday, are encouraged to wear any of their college gear. On Thursday, college hats in specific are allowed. On Friday, they acknowledge a future starts here at Penn by wearing Kingsman Spirit Wear. Outside of school, on Monday, September 23rd, the Century Center hosts a St. Joseph County College Fair from 6 to 7:30 p.m. with the financial aid seminar taking place before at 5:30. Admissions counselors from colleges all across the country are attending the fair to encourage and assist prospective students. Signing off from PNN, I'm Nate Zizzo.
Thanks, Nate.
Now to our new teacher feature of the week. Every week, we will highlight a new teacher here at Penn High School. This week's feature is Ms. Guillen Garcia. As a native Venezuelan, she started teaching English at 17 years old. Now at Penn, she teaches Spanish too.
I wouldn't say that I always wanted to be a teacher, because when I was younger in high school, I wanted to be so many other things. But when I experienced teaching for the first time, I realized that's what I wanted to do. The expectations, the procedures is different, but it has been great. I think I have a lot of support from everybody, and it's been a great experience so far.
Thanks, Ms. Guillen Garcia. We will be back next week with a new teacher feature.
If you couldn't tell by the decorations throughout the school, this school year's theme is a play on construction, officially titled Building Bright Futures. Marie Roach got the inside scoop on the theme from Dr. Geilhar. Now to you, Marie.
So when we think about construction, there are a lot of things that go into building something, right? So there's planning, there's dreaming and coming up with a vision of what you want to create, right? And so it starts with a foundation, and you have to create a blueprint for what you're going to build, right? And so when we talk to students, you know, especially freshmen and sophomores that might be still kind of thinking about, you know, what they want out of school and what their goals long term are. We want them to not only understand that high school is the foundation for success, but they should also be thinking about their own blueprint on what they want to achieve in life and what steps they need to take, right? So engagement is the most important thing that we focus on and we talk to our teachers about. So we want them creating environments where students are highly engaged, and you know, the cell phone distraction, I think, of years past is not where it used to be. I think it's less of a distraction now.
Yeah, I would agree.
And so I think that's been a positive change. You know, Penn High School is an amazing high school, and there's so many opportunities here. You know, I think about what we're doing right now and the students I'm walking with. You know, there are so many cool things that our students do each and every day, and it's a tribute to them. And I just want all of our students to know that every day you're here, it's an opportunity, right? It's an opportunity, it's not an obligation. Mm-hmm. I want students to think about, you know, what are they doing today that's gonna help them achieve the blueprint that they have designed for themselves. Mm-hmm. So then long term, they're gonna, you know, feel good about their experience in high school. Because if they do that, I think they're gonna have a great 4 years of high school and obviously a great school year this year.
Thank you, Marie. It's time for sports news with Noah.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to sports. My name is Noah Teeple, and today I have the biggest news in Penn sports. One of the largest cross-country meets in the state is happening tomorrow. Both the boys and girls cross-country teams will be heading to New Prairie for the historic New Prairie Invitational. Nate Tingle has more.
The New Prairie Invitational is one of the biggest in the state. Race began at 8 in the morning and lasts through 1 in the afternoon. The girls' team will be competing in the varsity class AAA race and girls' reserve race. The boys' team will be competing in three races, the varsity AAA race, boys' reserve race, and a New Prairie Classic, the boys' freshman and sophomore race. A lot is on the line for both teams this year after the state tournament redistricting and reformatting last year. The New Prairie course is home of the sectional and regional course for the Kingsmen. Tomorrow's meet will serve as a preview for Penn to see what it will take this year to advance to the state meet in Terre Haute. Aubrey Morgan is a senior varsity letterman on the girls' cross-country team. She is excited for tomorrow's race. Jack Ryan is a varsity letterman for the boys' cross-country team. He says the stakes are high heading into this weekend. Top 40 individual and top 5 teams will win awards at tomorrow's Invitational. If you would like to go and be part of the action, tickets will be on sale for $6 at the gate at New Prairie High School. Reporting for PNN, I'm Sports Director Nate Tingle.
Thank you, Nate. In our recruiting update, junior swimmer Elena Riggins has committed to Purdue University. Her start will be there in 2026. And that's all the big news I have for you today, Penn. Now to sports with everyone's favorite coaches.
Hey, Penn High School, welcome to the kingdom. Here we got the greatest sports show in television history. Wait a second. What do we got here?
What is it, coach?
The 134th Primetime Emmy Award after just one episode? This has been we just won the Primetime Emmy Award for the greatest sports cast in high school American history. So congratulations, Penn High School. This is the greatest sports show in American history. I'm Coach Cates, and I'm going to introduce you guys to Coach Harper.
So here we go. Are you ready for your announcements? It's football time. Friday Night Lights. That's right. Penn football takes on Marion Knights at 7 o'clock tonight. Are you ready to bring it? We need you to pack those stands. Broadcast on the Pennant is with Nate Zizzo and James Mason. The theme, students, is USA, USA. So we must pack those stands, Coach Cates.
Absolutely. Boys soccer, this past Wednesday, our boys soccer team played Mishawaka Marion. It's a Mishawaka Marion week again. Mishawaka Marion on the road and won 3-1. The Kingsmen are now 7-3-2. This upcoming Tuesday, our boys soccer team will take on South Bend Adams at home at 7 p.m. Good job and good luck, boys.
You know what we call that?
Domination.
Domination. How about girls soccer? This past Tuesday, our girls soccer team took on Marion as well. They had a tough, tough loss, but they're bouncing back strong. So here we go. All right. So now, tomorrow at noon. All right. Come on. Go up.
We're in it. This is
good.
We're in
it, baby. Soccer.
We love it.
All right. They just played Marion. Here we go. They will play Homestead. So good luck to the girls' soccer team. Here we go.
Girls golf. Girls golf team is competing in sectionals September 20th at Norwood Country Club at 9 a.m.
Woo!
Good luck to the girls' golf
volleyball team. This upcoming Thursday, our volleyball team will play South Bend Adams on the road at 7 p.m. Road trip, coach. Here it is.
Good luck to our volleyball team. Hey, Coach Harper, you want to do a new segment sponsored by the Hometown Hero Ice Cream or Urban Swirl Frozen Yogurt?
Be honored, Urban Swirl. Let's sponsor.
Okay, we got a new segment. Guess our guest of the day. We have, you right now you're sitting there thinking, who is this? Well, I'll tell you, give you some hints. 6'2", 6'3", full beard, a little bit of gray. That's all right, though. Huge Bears fan. But the Bears play the Colts this Sunday, so we went with the Colts. Stopwatch, track uniform. Take a guess on who our special guest is. 5, 4, 3, 2.
And he wears yellow shoes.
And he wears the brightest yellow shoes, Big Bird shoes you've ever seen in your life. Who is it?
I don't know. Who is it going to be? Can you guess? There it is. Have a great day. Fire up. Go, Penn.
Thanks, Noah and coaches. That's all we have for you today, Penn. Stay tuned into PNN every week for even more exciting Penn news.
Make sure to take care of yourself, each other, and this place. Have a fabulous Friday, Kingsmen.
It's tomorrow night.
Yes, tomorrow night. You can watch the broadcast on the... Just joking. It's tonight.
We woke up and we're feeling a little devious.
Stay tuned with PNN...